Well, howdy, passengers. We're gonna head up the coast now, okay? If you see any tentacles coming out of the water, disregard that. It's fine. That's just the boat purging its squid. Because we have squids. Well, anyway. Don't worry. Enjoy the ride. Now, it might be a little spooky, but this area is nice for fishing. That used to be my granddad's boat. He was an asshole. Shiny light. That's so pretty. Yeah, I don't give a shit there. Feller. Yeah, Alan. Shut up, Alan. I'll fucking stab you in your gullet. Shut up, Alan. No, I'm gonna fucking smack you in the mouth, I swear. So you can get back in your boat and leave. Alan, this isn't your dock. It belongs to the whole town. Yeah. Strangers are welcome. Sorry. You've caught us. But Alan's got a point. Not all visitors have good intentions. So, what's your business? Do I look like I could lead you astray? Nah. Microphone switch. What the fuck? VR, stop being stupid.
I didn't come all this way to be interrogated by the likes of you.
That's right, bitch.
I knew I should have wasted her.
Listen, my tone is short. It's because of dealing with knuckleheads like Alan Lee.
Yeah. More like a welcome party. Fuck you, Alan.
Unless they have a powerful good reason. Might be I can help.
What is this place?
Well, in ancient times, this used to be a tourist. My people lived here and on the island for generations.
Yo, people.
Crowded onto the docks.
What you mean, yo, people?
We have more than our fair share of problems. You're not here to add to them, are you?
I'm here to rape you. Don't be mad. Synth refuge.
About a synth refuge on this island.
Another Commonwealth traveler looking for a figure.
Mariners ain't coming.
You help us defend the town, and I'll answer any questions you have.
You got it, bitch. I'm going. I'm following you, even though you're slow.
Dude, might not be able to rescue you.
Hurry up, old lady. You shouldn't be worried about me. Believe me. Would it be? This ain't a dream. Oh. Okay. Look to the fog! Oh shit! They're coming! Come on, bitch. Let's go, gulper. You little punk-ass gulper. Fuck with me. Any more, you cock monkeys? Bruh, you're dead. Anybody else? No? Okay. Give her some cover and fire! There ain't nothing here. You crack baby. Where's the rest of them? There we go. This is too easy. You know what? Here, let me switch to something else. This is rape, okay? Like, that's what this is. Antifreeze bottle. Why are you eating antifreeze bottles, you dumb shit? Gulper innards. Is that it? Oh no. My dude's weak as shit. Damn it. Project. We can. Is this whole fucking place irradiated? That's stupid. All right.
Avery.
Captain Avery's alright. And why are you living here?
You deserve this. You managed to survive despite all that. You must be tough.
Or no, I'm done cowering behind your damn hull. Time you let me deal with the real problem. The right people and my guns, I can end those children of Adam cultists for good.
Dog's been here forever. The children didn't make it.
Before the rat eaters came, the fog was under control. They come, and all goes wrong. It's time we do something.
No need.
Because they're retarded. Children of Adam.
What's the deal with the children of Adam? They're religious. They worship the power of Adam.
There you know.
If you want details, you'd have to find them yourself.
Yeah.
That preacher came out of the harbor saying,
God, I'm gonna fucking punch you if you don't shut up.
It's Adam's goddamn will that we lost so many friends and family.
It's Adam's will.
If it were up to me, you
God damn it, Adam.
Preacher Alan. What did he do to the preacher?
Alan pulled the gun off. He claims the creature reached for his. We don't have boys. Really,
Alan, you're dumb. Fuck you.
And after everything the creature says, abundantly clear, doing anything to Alan would have made matters worse. Have the children made the fog worse?
Absolutely not. Not one bit of evidence.
Geiger counters don't lie. The fog's gotten more lethal year over year.
You retarded.
Now the fog's covering the whole island.
You know, as well as I do, that's happened before. Sure, people have theories that children are involved, but no one, and I mean no one, has proof.
Well, I'm gonna kill them all. So, have fun with that, and fuck you.
Sounds like you should deal with the children back. Permanently.
Mainlander sees the sense in all this.
I will do everything in my power to keep the peace here. So go. Sorry.
Get Alan. Get out of here, Alan. Little fuck boy.
No one knows the fog like you. But word of warning, he's a bit of an acquired taste.
Excuse me. Alright. Arcadia, let's see what that's all about.
Longfellow is the only one that's been
there. Fuck you and fuck Longfellow. God. Who is he?
Old Longfellow's Storm. He's the best hunter on the island. Fearless. I'm so crazy.
Yeah. Until he gets behind a spray and pray with over 3,000 rounds. We'll see. I will kill your entire town. Fuck you. Too much need a guy. I'll take him. And then kill him. Oh great, a drunk person at the bar. Of course my mic is going up. God damn it. That sucks.
And let me say something you might not hear again.
Yeah, yeah. Alright, where's the bar? What you guys got here? You got some good books?
If you need any odds and ends, man.
Does that fucking fish have syphilis? What the fuck? Speaking of which,
buying anything?
I'm on the fence.
Grab me. See something you like.
Yeah, whatever type of fucking fish this is, I don't want it. Teddy? Fuck you. Okay. Let's see. I don't like that. Who's this? Why are you wearing the same damn thing that dude was wearing at the last place? You're not Chinese! You don't get to wear that! Only Chinese are fishmen. Harvard woman. No, you look high as fuck, lady. Oh, he promised you it? Oh, I don't care. Oh, I'm overweight.
So what are we standing at all? For you. They call me the Mary.
Oh, yeah.
Why doesn't he help you? Each harborman is the captain of his own ship. Worked fine for generations on the homesteads. Your land, your rules. And the island pushed them onto my rock one by one. And ungrateful bastards expect me to look after my land. And though they're squatting, but wretched. It's not bad, right? I couldn't very well toss them back at all, but I... surely their spirits will haunt me to my grave.
I must have a lot of spirits following me.
For helping you out, I expect some appreciation. And thanks. You and me both have been saving these whelps for ages without even a word of thanks. I don't suppose you'd be willing to lend a hand. In order to do proper repairs, I need tools, specialized tools. And they won't be easy to come by. You put the walls together this time. I need special tools.
Give me the tools.
Keep those blasted crabs out.
No one likes crabs. Gotta get that special, you know, wash and soap. Yeah. That's no fun. Sure, I'll help keep the crabs out. Why not? Fuck you. Get out of here, lady. Where is the drunk guy that I need to talk to get this shit started? Damn it. I don't want none of your herpes fish, okay? Get it away from me. Herpes fish. You look like... She looks like... What's that chick's name? From Sanctuary. Oh, I... Sanctuary is gonna be a real good place one day. Fuck, who is that? I can't remember. Oh well. Oh, yeah? But fucking hurry up then. Oh, yeah? Generations. It was lumber and fishing that made the Dantes rich. Oh, yeah, that one lumber? Huh? Took too much from the island's been raping your mouth ever since. The island's been raping your mouth because it took its wood. Why am I always the mysterious stranger? It's like, oh, look at this guy. Look at this new guy. Here. Just become, like, the leader of my gang. Just do that. Oh, I just met you? We're trying to kill you? Oh, yeah, guess what? You're the leader of the gang now. Like, this is what I don't get. There's no, like, uptick, you know what I mean? There needs to be, like, okay... You show up, okay, you're a fucking grunt. Go do some work. Go rob some people. Not, oh, you got through the thing and killed the guy with a squirt gun. Here you go. Here's the whole fucking gang. I don't know. I feel like they could have done better on the DLC, man. Main game, I think, was fucking awesome. Like, the whole different, like, siding with the railroad and all that. That's kind of cool. But there was no, I guess there's really no, yeah, there's more uptick to that. You know what I mean? Like, you have to do some missions. I'm sorry, I'm getting off topic. Let's fucking, you mean me. Are you saying that I'm the mysterious stranger who's going to pull a bunch of things? Well, no shit. Apparently not, because I had... Never mind. No shit.
Come to the first chapter.
Freckleface Pete. Are we going to see Freckleface Pete? But he's dead. The island. The sneaky island.
I'll
avenge Petey. Maybe Petey was retarded. Did you ever think of that? You old fucking... I don't even know what to call you. You just look fucking weird. Quit looking at me. Look away. Jeez. Ooh, look at that fisherman. Fisherman. Harborman. Fisherman. Harborman. Hard work. Wait. Oh, that's Harborman. Harborman. Small Bertha. You look just like that chick from fucking Diamond City. Don't even try it. And then you look like the bald kid. Come on, man. You can't design some kids, man. You know what? Kid from the Institute is literally this motherfucker right here with hair. Fuck you, game. Come on, now. You gotta try a little harder than that. Let's talk to Small Bertha. About to get slapped, little kid. I swear to God, I'll beat your ass. I don't care. I'll punch you right in your fart box, okay? Don't fucking talk back to me.
Give me a room, see?
Hey, Debbie. Debbie. God, you guys all look like you're fucked. Talk to Debbie.
I'm still deciding. Grab me if you need me.
I don't want any drinks, Debbie. Hey, look at this. Are you part of the Atom Cats, bud?
What's the catch?
Not a catch to be found. Full bar ain't no use to a court. So, drink up. Stay here over long and I'll claim you. Fire, eh?
What's so special about the fog on the island?
Can't you feel it? Even here, as safe as anywhere, stay alive. It's a lie. You walk in.
It's a lie.
In no time.
I'm retarded. It's alive. Get away from me, Debbie. God, what are you doing?
The trappers you find in there, some were always murderous flowers. But many just got lost in the fog. For too long. I'm gone. If you have any sense, return where you came from.
Then why are you here, you dumb shit? Why do you
stay? If it's so dangerous, why do you stay?
This is our home. Call yourself a proper woman. That. Besides, we all die. Might as well do it with your long knife deep in the belly of the beast that wrongs you. Ha!
You're retarded. Why is everybody crazy here? Fuck you, Mitch. Get away from me. You better shut up, Debbie. I'll kick you right in the fucking pooper, okay? You shut up. You look stoned as shit. You should be fired. I'm just kidding. I'm stoned as shit, too. What is this?
Perfect.
Shut up, you crazy cunt! Oh, look at a kitty. Can I stab it? I'm going to stab your pussy. This motherfucker is giving away free drinks.
Captain Avery said you can get me to Acadia?
You get your hands dirty?
Tell me about Acadia.
Strange folk. They call themselves Sikhs. Means to me that it just might be left. They've done some good things for some of us. Fog does, most especially. They need to be a far harbor left. Not Rogers.
I'm not some no-name name. I'm tough enough to be a little island.
Oh, yeah.
Really? Do I look like your average man on that?
Truth be told, no. It goes against
me. I have a top hat, okay? Any motherfucker in a top hat, you better be worried. The guy I killed for this top hat was, like, teleporting and shit. Okay? And he's still dead.
Should I make any other preparations?
Ammo, skin packs, no rocket launcher. Worse than
that. I need to take care of a few things.
Rocketer 3, okay. Okay. Yeah, let's check and see what we got here. Rocketer 3. Oh, look at that. Just so you know, I got a spray and pray that explodes every time you fucking shoot it, and I've got 2,000 ammo for it. So, yeah, pretty much everything's dead. And if that don't work, let's see. Oh, I got some cannonballs. I don't even know. Oh, it's for that stupid. Yeah, I got rid of that. Fusion cell. Yeah, okay. 2,000 fusion cells. A shit ton of cores because, you know. Whatever. And 174 missiles. And 15 mini nukes. And 4 nuka nukes. I think I can handle it there, bud. A few rockets. Yeah. Fuck you. Think I got it covered. Shut up about your pussy, okay? I don't want to hear.
Life's too bloody short to be sober.
Yeah, and it's too bloody short to listen to your dumb fucking ass. I'm going to sleep. Okay? Fuck off. Gonna sleep for like, you know, 5 hours, I guess. Or whatever. Kia, bitch.
I, for one, won't go down unless I'm roaring drunk. Cheap booze.
Just so you know, I was eating Cheez-Its. They were good. So I buy a room, and I don't even get a stash box. I'm gonna murder you, Mitch. Alright, hey. Come on, long dong, dick lock. Don't lure me around.
You wanna make this a one-way trip? By all means. If you wanna live, you
let's go, Longfellow.
Follow me.
That's what I said, long dong, dick lock, let's go. Old Longfellow. Old Dumbfellow. Either one. Doesn't matter. I'm gonna tell you, people. A real tragic thing has happened. Fuck you. I have run out of beer. Let's see what this guy's saying. Oh, we're done talking. Gotcha. Come on, old long John Dicklock. Let's go. Oh shit, I'm over encumbered. Go, fuck boy. I don't have all day. Being real, we're fucking sneaky here. Let's make it there. Fucking radiation everywhere on this island. That's gonna... Be fucking hard out, bitch. Fuck with me. Oh god. Do you have a hook? It's a meat hook. I'm taking that. Thank you. Where's the rest of you some bitches? Hi, how you doing? See you later. Coastal armor. Ow, what the fuck, dude? That's not even cool. That fucking hurt. Let's get it, you some bitch. Some bitch. Like a somebody. What? What do you say to me or something? God. Is a meat hook really that much? What are you talking about? God damn it. The Legend of Vault 88. Alright, come here, buddy. I need to have you carry some stuff. Look, Fred Stagney. Come here. You're not half bad in the scrap. Oh yeah, some local wildlife? Okay. Think we can handle
eventually rolled about. People reset. But they were comfortable. They started taking things for granted. Folk got short of money. All this happened before.
Oh, yeah. Why is there just random barrels of radiation or nuclear material just laying around? Like, it's fucking everywhere. What the, what? Why? Oh, Jesus. Bitch, seeing as you don't have any goddamn hair.
Yeah, whatever you say. Watch yourself.
What?
You want the ads.
Fucking punch you in the cunt. About to kill you. take a quick break. I'll be back.
Sweet mom. When I first climbed this mountain above the fog, I thought to myself, now here is a metaphor worth taking in. You've entered a place of clarity, understanding, peace. While you're here in Acadia, Synthkind welcomes you as long as you welcome us.
Well, in that case, I want a new cola, some stim packs, Kasumi Nakano returned to her family, and, a pony.
I see. I'm afraid some of those things I'm not in a position to give. Kasumi is here. She's safe and unharmed, and you're free to see her if you'd like. Before you do, though, tell me, do you think Kasumi is a synth?
Why are you asking?
Because she came here with that very question. And the answer changes every part of her world. None of us take this transition lightly. She's facing the possibility of her entire life being a lie. That someone stripped her very identity from her and made her into something she isn't. I want you to understand that before you see her. She has a chance here to live as a synth, not hiding, not pretending to be something else. One more question, if you'll indulge me. You're here for Kasumi, but I suspect there could be another reason you came to us. Tell me, are you a synth?
If I squint real hard in the mirror, sometimes I look like someone else.
I'm afraid when I try that trick, nothing really changes. I know it might seem impossible that you could be a synth, but tell me, what's the first thing you can remember?
I'm not going to tell my life story to someone I barely know. Let's hear your answer first.
I was in a laboratory, in the Institute. They were pulling pieces of my head out. Something about wanting to test some neural process. That was every day for months. Strapped down, operated on, and then I was out. The Institute has fail-safes to strip memories that could identify where they are, how to find them. But I do remember being quite content. I was free. That is my earliest memory. Now, yours.
was with my husband. We were getting ready for the day. I had to take care of my son, Sean. And well, lots happened since then.
But no memories before then? No childhood? Your first best friend? Your first kiss? That's usually a sign. Data is easy to migrate, but feelings, that's a hard thing to transfer into another mind. Isn't it funny how a memory can feel like a whole different reality? People, places, even sounds and colors can change. Or someone else has changed them. I won't lie to you. There will always be other explanations. Trauma, disease, the background radiation. They all take their toll on the mind. But I can promise you that you will be accepted here. Whatever you decide is true for yourself.
I've heard enough. Where is Kasumi Nakano?
Of course. Kasumi is usually working down below. You can see her whenever you like. Acadia is open to you. Feel free to walk the grounds. Introduce yourself to my co-founders, Faraday and Chase. Did you need anything else before you go?
I'm part of a group that helps synths. A railroad.
Really? I don't understand why a group dedicated to helping synths would convince them through fear that their only option is to hide. Yes, they volunteer for the memory wipe. Yes, not knowing you're a synth makes it harder for the Institute to find you. But the cost, I know how frightening it is. The risk of capture, but sacrificing what you are, avoiding the true struggle to be accepted as our own form of life.
Ideals aren't going to protect escape sense. We do what we have to.
I know that's what you think. I just... No. No, I shouldn't judge. I'm over here, far from the Commonwealth, in relative safety. Is there anything else you'd like to discuss?
So everyone here in Acadia is a synth?
Yes. Either they were escapees we managed to find before the Institute could, or they were victims of the mind wipe, and we revealed the truth.
Tell me more about this place, Acadia.
All I want is to bring as many synths here as I can and give them a chance to know what they really are, to embrace it. Beyond that, we just want to live in peace. I don't have any grand plans for expansion. Just existing as we are now is enough. Was there anything else?
I should get going.
Of course.
You haven't been in there a long time. Are you feeling all right?
I'm fine. You worry too much.
Sometimes I feel like you don't worry enough. You know we blew 3 more relays this week. I'm coming in. You stay right there.
Hey there.
So, you've talked to Dima. You know why we're here. I certainly hope that you'll consider helping us. Dima's vision is worth fighting for.
So you're a synth?
I am. I hope that's not a problem for you. Dima has worked hard to create a place for us where we can be safe from those who don't accept us. He's put so much of himself into this. All his time and energy devoted to helping others. He never stops to think of himself. Sometimes I worry about... Well, if if I wasn't here to make sure his equipment is all functional. And that's not even mentioning maintaining the fog condensers. So many things to keep track of.
Hi. What do you want, Emin? Blowing a fuse, huh?
No, not really.
Can you tell me about the fog condensers?
Oh, those? Dima and I designed them when it became clear the fog was only getting worse. They're effective, but have such a limited range. Dima insisted we provide them to the people of Far Harbor, and I'm so glad we did. Without the condensers, I'm not sure they'd have anywhere left.
Dima looks like he's had a lot of work done.
Well, that's certainly an understatement. Between the two of us, we've made so many modifications. It was just a prototype, never built for all this. It took a lot to overcome the limitations of the original design and expand his memory. It really is remarkable, isn't it? He's overcome so much. He's become so much more than he once was. And all he thinks of is others.
If there's anything I can do to help out, just let me know.
Well, if you're determined to help, there is something you could do. It's likely somewhat dangerous, though, so I understand if you'd rather not. There's a boat along the coast of the island. It was transporting some hardware we needed. Storage drives. The boat never finished the trip, you see. So the drives are still out there. I could really use them here for extra parts, if nothing else. My understanding is that the boat wrecked southwest of here. So, does this sound like something you could handle?
What happened to the boat? Why didn't it make it?
I'm not entirely sure, to be honest. Trappers, fog crawlers, there's no end to what's out there. What might still be out there. The point is that we already lost someone once. And I don't want to see that happen again. So, are you up for it?
I don't do much for free, Faraday.
Ah, right. Of course. I should have thought of that. How does 100 caps sound?
Didn't you say this might be dangerous? 100 caps seems a little light if danger is involved.
Well, yes, there is that possibility. Would 200 caps be more agreeable?
Sure thing, Faraday. I'll get the drives for you.
Thank you. I really do appreciate it.
Need the key. Dima?
Acadia is open to you. Did you need anything?
I should get going.
Of course.
Don't have the key.
You track Kasumi here. I'm impressed. Perhaps not as quietly or efficiently as possible, but thankfully she was never in any real danger. I'm afraid your journey was unnecessary.
It's not them. I'm concerned about you.
So you're saying you could have done a better job of it? Didn't know it was a competition.
Yes, absolutely. Acadia is a safe haven for synths. Were it not, I would not have aided anyone in reaching it. Every synth I've tracked down, every synth convinced to come here, has been assured that he or she will come to no harm. My job is to make sure they all remain safe, no matter what. Understand?
How do you manage to track down synths and bring them here?
I have a network of contacts throughout the area. Some from my time with the Institute, some after. I know the Institute's tactics, and use that to my advantage. You have Dima's blessing, so by all means, make yourself comfortable.
So, what's your story?
I used to be a courser, returning synths that had escaped from the Institute. I was tracking a synth and instead found Dima. He convinced me of the truth and the error of my ways. I rejected the Institute, made sure they couldn't track me, and dedicated my life to instead helping synths find freedom.
Tell me about Acadia.
Dima's told you most of what you need to know. It's as safe as we can make it for now. With every new synth we rescue, we're better able to defend ourselves.
I'd like to help you all. Is there anything I can do?
Actually, as a matter of fact, there is. If you're serious about contributing, well, we've got a situation I need someone to look into. You've had some experience traveling around the island, so you may be decently equipped to handle it.
What's the problem?
We were expecting a new synth to arrive, and he should have been here by now. There's been no sign of him, and I'm concerned that he might have become lost on the way here.
You have any leads on where he might be?
You should start by talking to Brooks in Far Harbor. He's one of us, a synth. He's the one who meets the new arrivals and gets them started on the journey here. Of course, he's not likely to tell you anything without proof that you're working for me. If he doesn't cooperate, tell him that his designation is L792. That should convince him. That's as much help as I can give you for now. Please, hurry. If that synth is out there alone, he won't last long.
Brooks is a mainlander, too. And a synth.
Whatever that is.
You got caps. I got goods.
I need to talk to you about a missing synth.
Yeah? Well, it's not something I talk about with outsiders. So you can either buy something or move along.
That famous Bar Harbor hospitality. How could you not love it?
It grows on you. Will it be anything else?
I'm working with Chase. She told me that your designation is L792.
Okay, I believe you. Keep it down, all right? It's real private information. I know the synth you're talking about. He's a younger guy. Maybe early 20s with white hair. Goes by the name Derek. Thing is, he showed up way earlier than he was supposed to. Thought a courser was on his tail, so he rushed the timetable. To be honest, the guy was a wreck. He was scared shitless, looking over his shoulder every 5 minutes and attracting unwanted attention. Tried to calm him down, but he panicked and ran off into the fog. That was the last I saw of him.
Can you tell me anything else? I'm gonna need more information than that if I'm gonna find the synth.
I wish I had more to give you. He disappeared into the fog, and I haven't seen him since.
You let him run off alone?
What the hell was I supposed to do? I'm on my own here. Look, if you're really going after that synth, I'm pretty sure he took the road south out of town. Well, you could head that way. Just be careful out there. And thanks. There aren't many who'd go out in the fog to help a synth, especially one they don't even know. I feel like shit about what happened. I really do. I hope you can make it right. What the hell is this?
A stranger came to town that might help you. That's the best I can offer.
This is ridiculous.
Fresh shipment. All your medical and food
needs.
I'm sorry, but I don't have time for this.
By my guns.
This is ridiculous. You're in charge here. You can't just ignore a crime.
A stranger came to town that might help you. That's the best I can offer.
Ah, you there. Are you that detective I've heard about?
Who said I was a detective?
Mayor Avery said that someone new had arrived on the island, investigating a missing person. That must be you. I haven't been able to find any of the local police force, the louts. I don't want to start a panic, but, well, we may have a murder on our hands, and we need an outside set of eyes.
Where did the crime take place?
At the Cliff's Edge Hotel, just north of the town. Please, you must help us. Every moment we wait, our residents are at risk.
Who's the victim?
Well, we want to keep this out of the tabloids, but it's Ezra Parker, the financier of the hotel. Will you help us? There may still be a murderer at large.
Who are your employers?
I shouldn't say out here in the open, but my employers are quite wealthy, as are the other patrons of the hotel. Will you help us solve this heinous crime?
Okay, I'll help.
Oh, thank goodness. Shall I guide you to the Cliff's Edge Hotel now?
Where is it again?
Yeah, let's go.
Let's be off then.
Front.
Like it isn't just the police who have been lax lately. The Idlands building inspector ought to be fired. The hotel staff really needs to do something about the lobby. I should warn you, some of the other hotel guests are a bit, rowdy. I was forced to defend myself when a few became a bit handsy, shall we say. The registered patrons are in a more exclusive area of the hotel, though, and do not associate with this sort of rabble. Shall we be off?
Yeah. Let's go.
Very good. This way.
teach you.
Watch your step. Bit of a mess in here.
Keep saying to myself I should settle down someday. Think I missed the boat. We ain't right here. What we can't do. Thank you.
This elevator leads to the exclusive area of the hotel. You should feel quite privileged that they will be allowing you in. After you, the elevator is right there. Need to speak to Maxwell. Go ahead and activate the control panel there.
Let me just get the door for you. Well, it's about time the police set up to investigate. We have many important residents, and they are very worried.
Let's talk about my compensation first.
Very well. Consider this a retainer. They're at the crime scene again. Don't they realize that they're going to disturb the evidence? You'd better come with me, Detective.
I shall return to my workstation and allow you to take things from here.
Shouting.
But the detective has arrived and shall begin the investigation henceforth.
Please return to your rooms until the detective has examined the crime scene and had a chance to come speak with you.
Hello, detective.
How can I help? Did you have questions about the case?
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
It's obviously Santiago. He keeps going back to look at the crime scene.
Tell me about yourself.
Well, as you probably know, I'm an actor. I don't like to brag about it, but my last picture, The Fighting Furies, it topped the box office.
Never mind.
Okay. Just let me know how I can help.
Have a look at the crime scene for clues. Already, we discuss your plan. You are free to question the residents, but their safety is our priority. So unless you have some...
Is this blood? Looks like the brain enclosure was smashed. Yes. A baseball bat? Huh. What's this doing here? Talk about the murder.
There will be plenty of time for that. We have more important matters to attend to. Come with me. Tell me, what does this piece say to you?
It looks kind of like a face. That spot is the eye, the red blotch is its hair, and it's sticking its tongue out.
Indeed. This was the last piece I did in a series of portraits of Gilda. Number 1378. Her emotional landscape is superimposed on the portrait. The reality of the subject is distorted as the ego attempts to project itself. This way. Tell me, what does this one say to you?
It's the war! Bombs from every direction. No up or down. The world turned on its head.
I suppose in a way it must be. Art shapes the world, and the world shapes art in return. All art must therefore be constantly reborn through the lens of contextual and historic interpretation. It must ascend. And what about this one? And please be honest, for art without honesty is just politics.
It's cute, I guess. Some people like that kind of thing.
More than you would imagine. Truth be told, this is my best-selling piece. I did this series under a pseudonym, of course. This series has made more money than any of my serious works. And I did the whole thing as a lark. What does that tell you about the value of art to the common man, huh? My fellow connoisseur of the art, here to see my latest work.
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
The person you should be looking at is Juliana Riggs. That Philistine would not know art from her own excrement. She and Ezra had a rather dramatic fight recently. You could hear her banshee screeches all the way across the hotel.
What were Juliana and Ezra arguing about?
I don't know. I was painting at the time and I was trying to block it out. Though I bet Gilda probably heard them. Maybe you should check with her.
I think you should explain why you keep returning to the crime scene.
It's for inspiration, Detective. The others do not like to think about it, but even we shall die someday. Like Prometheus's torch, it kindles within me the fire to create as much art as I can with the time that I have.
It sounds like you've done a lot of painting as a Gilda. Why her?
Our Gilda is a very singular creature, Detective. Do you not see the joie de vivre from within her? I have never met another who clings to life so tenaciously, who lives so in the moment. I must admit I was quite smitten with her for a time.
You're still in love with Gilda, aren't you?
So what if I am? What business is...
Never mind.
My fellow connoisseur of the art.
Maybe later.
Good. My fellow connoisseur of...
Tell me about yourself.
What is there to tell? My work is primarily in oil paint. But I have been known to do sculpture or performance art as well.
Never mind.
Hello, Mr. Whiskers. Who's a pretty kitty? Hello, Detective. Did you have a question about...
Mr. Whiskers died last month. This is Cluffy. Remember?
I heard you had a big fight with Ezra a few days ago. Care to explain?
Oh, well, it wasn't that big a deal, really. He wanted more money to pay for repairs on the hotel. I wasn't feeling well that day and lashed out a bit at the poor man. I really should have listened to him more.
Did you have any thoughts about... the murder?
If you ask me, it's one of those actors. Or that horrible painter. Their type is always the cause of violence.
What's with all the junk in here?
These are our things.
Tell me about yourself.
I'm Juliana Riggs.
Maybe later.
Good luck catching... Oh. Of course.
I heard that Juliana and Ezra had an argument a few days before he was found dead. Tell me about that.
Well, I was in my lab at the time, so I didn't hear it. But Juliana has always been rather critical of Mr. Parker. I think she found something in the overseer's office. I wasn't listening when she... told me about it. I kind of had my head in my research. I don't know, really. I try to let her handle all the money stuff. Oh, was there something else, Detective?
Have you noticed Juliana acting strangely lately?
Oh, well, I'm probably just being paranoid, but she's been so much more pleasant lately. I mean, it's been nice, but also a bit unnerving. Most people don't really understand us, but I always appreciated how she can just take charge of a situation. It's what allowed me to focus on my research. I'm worried something has happened to her. She doesn't seem like the same person. Oh, was there something else, Detective?
What do you mean? Juliana's not the same person.
My wife has always been a very harsh woman, Detective. I don't know who it is in our rooms, but that is not my wife, Detective. Oh, was there something else, Detective?
Did
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
Yeah, I don't want to talk about this anymore. Please just go. Just let me have a look at the neural interface matrix.
Hello, Detective.
I'm sure I can clear that.
Did you have a question about the heinous murder?
Tell me about yourself.
I'm Juliana Riggs.
Never mind.
Good luck catching the murderer, Detective. No, it's not that. I've just caught another cold. Probably something that got in when they sent Pearl out.
Oh, God. Not this again. Last month you were convinced you had the measles.
You're not a doctor. What would you even know about it? Besides, I think it may be Berlin.
Protect and serve.
Hello again, Detective. Was there anything else?
I found the murder weapon.
Oh, no. That's the bat from Mr. McKinney's movie. You don't think he could be involved, do you? I can't imagine him ever doing such a thing. Was there anything else?
Your residents are robots.
Not robots, Detective. Well, not exactly, anyway. I believe the term they use is robo-brain. Back before the war, the residents decided the best way to wait it out was to put their brains inside robotic chassis. Was there anything else?
I'm not sure where I should start.
I suppose you should try to figure out how he died, and then who had the means and motive to kill him. Once you have enough evidence, then I suppose you'll need to confront the killer. Was there anything else?
Tell me about the victim.
Mr. Ezra Parker was the primary owner and financier for the hotel. He had vast experience managing venture projects around the world. It was his idea to have our premier clients become investors in the vault section of the hotel. He worked with Vault Tech to have this built to their every specification. Was there anything else?
Never mind.
I'll be here should you need me.
Protect and serve.
Sealing yourself up in a steel hole.
Hello, Detective. Did you have a question about the heinous murder?
Out of hell for another one.
Did you have any...
If you ask me, it's one of those actors.
Tell me about yourself.
I'm Julia...
Never mind.
Good luck, Kim.
Hello again, Detective. Was there anything else?
The door to the Overseer's office is locked.
Oh, yes. Mr. Parker locked it a while back, after finding out that one of the other residents had been inside. Said it wasn't safe. If the key isn't on him, it's probably in Mr. Parker's room. Was there anything else?
Never mind.
I'll be here, should you need me.
Protect and serve.
There we go.
Progress on construction of the second wing of the vault is completely stalled. Once the premier area of the vault had been completed, funding seems to have been cut off. My supervisors have informed me that they haven't received payment from Mr. Parker, and Vault-Tec won't pay out of pocket to continue construction. I've repeatedly approached Ezra about the finances, but he keeps telling me that Mrs. Riggs hasn't transferred the funds. However, when I asked her, Juliana said that she had just given Ezra extra for the gold paint in the rooms. I've hired an investigator to look for signs of embezzlement in a few weeks.
Sounds like Ezra was embezzling from his investors. Never mind.
Okay. Just let me know how I can help.
Forget it. I can't do this right now.
Hello, Detective. How can I help? Did you have questions about the case?
I found your baseball bat at the crime scene. Care to explain how it got there?
Someone is clearly trying to frame me for the murder. It's probably Santiago. You saw him skulking around the crime scene.
What were you and Gilda talking about when I walked in?
Oh, we were just rehearsing a scene. Nothing to worry about.
I think you're the murderer. The brain enclosure was smashed in, and your bat was at the scene of the crime.
What? That makes no sense at all. What motive would I possibly have to kill Ezra?
can give me a reason it couldn't be you.
I would never harm Ezra Detective. I was in love with him.
Tell me about you and Ezra.
Oh, God, I don't know. When we first met him, he was just so mysterious and exciting. It seemed like he had been everywhere and done everything. I convinced Gilda that we should invest in the hotel so I could stay close to him. But he never seemed to realize how I felt. I mean, we spent time together. Going hunting, having drinks, talking about his plans for the hotel. He must have known, but he never said anything. Do you have any idea what it's like to pine for someone for 200 years, Detective?
Tell me about yourself.
We went over this before, Detective.
Maybe you can give me a reason. Tell me about yourself.
We went over this before.
I don't know yet, but I'll find the motive.
No, you won't, Detective.
Uh-huh.